Simon from the San Jose Mercury News. I mean, that crazy interception, I mean, did you have any doubt in your mind that it was going to maybe get overturned with all of the replay reviews we had tonight, and kind of it seemed like it was a little bit of a mystery as to what the call was going to be off the replay?
Yeah, not that one. I knew I had that one the whole way through. It was a good call by our defensive coordinator, though. They tried to run a scheme that we've been practicing on all week, and it played out in the game, and it went in our favor.
The cliche is bend but don't break, but right. I mean, they had a couple of drives right to the red zone, and you get the nice diving interception, and then that end of the first half stop right at the last second. It kind of turns out those were enormous for you guys in hindsight. Mm-hmm. How much of this group kind of is able to push out how well they're driving down the field when you get that close to your own end zone?
Yeah, as a defense, I mean, one of the things we preach all the time is just play. We got so many dynamic and good players on our team. On the defense, you feel me, that as long as we play, like the rest will take care of itself, we feel like. So on the sideline, we knew we didn't come out as strong as we wanted to, but we knew if we just kept pushing the message of just balling and just everything was going to play out the way it should, as it did.
Jordan, on the interception, what was the reaction to the scheme, the read that you reacted to? What was that particular thing you were looking at there?
I knew they were trying to get something short, and I took a chance. I jumped it. I seen it. I was kind of just trusting my instincts, and it played out in my favor. It was great pressure by the defensive line. They was really getting through them, through that O-line towards the second half. And, yeah, I seen the opportunity, and I had to take it.
How much is Perry? Coach Odom, like latitude give you guys to, you know, to react or maybe just do something a little mm-hmm. extra on the scheme.
Yeah, we're big on scheme, but he tells us all the time, like as players, we got to make the best decision at the right time. So he fully trusts us to make those kind of decisions and make those kind of plays. And at the end of the day, we trust each other. So even if it wasn't me, I know a bunch of the other guys on the team would have been able to make that same decision, and we all trust that. Oh yeah, that was a big stop on the at the end of the half. The kind of pressure that they were bringing out, I don't think we was ready for at the beginning, but I feel like as the defense, we kind of locked in, especially towards the end of that first half. And honestly, I'm a big run guy, so I was thinking run the whole way. And so I seen the guards and the centers coming down, and I just tried to play my gap, and the ball found me, and I was able to make a play on it.
On a game like this, you know, they really were able to methodically keep moving the ball on you guys all night. They controlled time of possession. They outgamed your guys' offense. Just, is there a point on defense where you I don't want to say it's demoralizing, but it's kind of like, dang, we really can't put them away right now. Does that thought come in?
It's never demoralizing, but once again, we trust our defense. I think the amount of trust that we have as a defense is crazy. I've never been a part of a defense like that, because Portland State did come out on fire, and they brought it the whole game. And I think the trust and the love as a defense that we build through practice and fall camp and all that, I think that's what showed late in that first half and late in the second half as well. But I love it. I love that kind of energy, that kind of chemistry. It feels good to play around some guys like that.
I guess how can a game like this, even if it's, you know, an FCS team, but you're pulling at a close win, you're needing everybody to do that tiny little thing, how much can that kind of be the boost into, you know, the next 11 in that way?
Oh yeah. To me, it starts in practice. You know, we've been trying to push the pace in practice a lot, especially these past couple months. And I think tonight shows we just got to keep on pushing. And it worked on our favor tonight. But I think we're all kind of excited to get back on practice on Monday and get back after it, you know, tighten things up and everything like that.
Matt, I want to go back to the O-line stand going into the half. Can you pinpoint some of those guys who maybe fans don't pick up, but they actually have a huge goal in making that play happen?
Man, our D-line is nasty. I never played with a D-line like this. They got the size, they got the brains, they got the reactiveness, and they make it makes it so easy to play linebacker when you have a very good D-line. It helps me out tremendously. I'm able to make those plays and those split decisions and trust that I have the guys around me to where I'm not exposing myself in any kind of negative way. So, yeah, I definitely kudos to my D-line, man, always.
All right, very cool.
and just your thoughts, comments on Dante Shashway, the quarterback.
Oh, he's a baller, man. we didn't have much film on him like last year, so we didn't see much from him. But he came out blazing. He made some big time throws. I called myself a couple times, like, wow, he made that throw, he fit that in there. But yeah, he balled for sure.
All right, thank you, Jordan.
Appreciate you.